themselves the Guardians of the Galaxy.
What a bunch of a-holes.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and welcome all across the world on Twitch.tv and Hitbox to RFPW presenting Boom 57. Today we kick off with a women's match scheduled for one fall, and for introducing first the super hardcore anime, All of His Know. It's a tongue breaker. But it always worked out in the end. Former Glamazons champion in action here tonight. I'm looking forward to some good things today as Tunde Kanni faces Flora Silk in the return of the Dudettes Tag Team Championship. And in the main event, Joe Coffey takes on BT Gunn in a steel cage. Ladies and gentlemen, your opponent for tonight is Kimberly. And Kimberly is one that's not very good at the moment. Because Kimberly, let's take a look at the facts, 2-2-3. Well, there are some bigger losses. Take Jessica Thunder, 0-6, 6 losses. We've also had to release Leah Von Dutch. Quite a bit of sad moments. But Leah Von Dutch has parted ways following Fight Night and a disappointing contributions, etc. And also we have news for you. Nathan Cruz is coming back to RFPW. He won an online fan vote with 79% of the votes. Former Genius TV champion and tag team champion with Dylan Bostick. And now Harry Dylan Bostick only got 21% in the vote out of those two, so Nathan Cruz will be coming back in around 2 weeks to you, back on track. And you can leave those replies and see a lot of those articles on rfpw2014.weebly.com. Later on today, we'll also be putting out an article about the point system, because there will be a point system in place which runs alongside the Order of Merit. The point system goes very easily. Get a victory, score 2 points, draw is 1, and a loss is 0. Except when there's a win, a championship win or a loss, a 60-day reign, triple threat of fatal four-way wins, etc., etc. They generate additional points. For example, just by winning matches, 7 matches won, Joe Coffey got 14 points and gets an additional 1 for being 60 days crowned as champion, and thus on 15 lands the top spot in the points. He's also, of course, the number 1 in the Order of Merit. But it will also generate some additional amount of money at the end of the year. We're going in total balance according to our audience, how much fans are tuning in, how much money are we taking in. And based on that, we'll be able to expand the total amount of prize money in that fund for as well women as men. And that will be paid out at the end of the year. So wrestlers would get a good amount of money at the end of the year on their contos. Of course, should they leave in the meantime, likely Evan Dutch, they will still receive that payout, but at also at the end of the year, because you don't know what that final balance is going to be. That sort of mega jackpot that's going to be divided over all the players. That sounds like a fair lottery. Everybody wins. Oh, dude! Just a look at how much you get. There we go! Oh, Kimberly very close to the victory and could have earned 2 points. And of course, we are looking into additional things. We've got the match of the week, now we've got the point system. Also trying to award a match of the show. not going into the record books, but still, we will hand it out, so it will be in the archives forever. Jesus. Oh my god! Top rope Hurricane Rana! Holy shit! This program is PG-13 and sponsored by OWTV, the Wrestling Matters Podcast. Non-stop sport and wrestling, AK Online Universe, Cyber Wrestling Entertainment, and Crucial Gaming. Backstabber! Jeez, that could end it all. Lufisto, on to the victory here and 2 points. No, just a one count. Lufisto currently... excuse me. On 4 points, Kimberly also on 4. So somebody's got to rise up in the points. Of course, that point might not reflect the order of merit if there are more matches, because they came in earlier. They will be higher in the order of merit. But the points, it will always be equal according to their wins. Making sure to upgrade the fairness of the systems. Oops. Ouch. Now that's probably gonna hurt. Oh, goodness. And of course, we're not only on the YouTube network with RFPW 2014, but we are also added to TRF TV on Daily Motion. So all those shows in a matter of time, in around a year or so, we'll be up. We have uploaded all content. Jesus. Up. Nicely done. Got the stretch. Now she's pulling the hook. If she gets a submission victory, that will be an additional point. Only submission ever since the introduction of the Order of Merit, etc. Camilla Leonuk winning Tanya Silkovic. I hope we got that right in the statistics, though. As we said, Flora Liberty, but that is not right. It's Camilla Leonuk. We did add that in the right way, but not written it down completely. Oh! And of course, Viper is the one to win the Women's Premier League, and therefore got 2 points. Joe Coffey got none for that as he finished as runner-up. Only the winner got additional points. All that appointed by the board. If you want more information on that, feel free to tweet out to us, RFPW2014, or email theragingfalcon@gmail.com. Oh, good splash! She bounced really off her. Jeez. And that's three. And that makes Lufisto 3-5, 6 points, and €720 on the clock. She's in number 2 contender right now. Good on her. Keep rising like this. Oh, God. Jesus. It's not my night tonight, as you can tell. Ladies and gentlemen, we're back, of course, in the RFPW Arena in Valkenburg, the Netherlands. And it's London calling, ladies and gentlemen. Not from London, poor London. Yeah, it's from the USA. Okay. But still, we get what you're on to. There's going to be a... Jesus, it's not working in my favor today. There's a flyaway division matchup. And of course, scheduled for one fall. Now, ladies and gentlemen, from Cape Town, South Africa, just like Camilla Leonuk, ladies and gentlemen, PJ Black. PJ's number 4 contender in the flyweight division, only at one match. In that initial triple threat for the title, the Will Ospreay ran away with it, and he lost it quite easily to Jeffrey. So, well, there we go. PJ Black, USA versus South Africa. I'm so sorry. Get your facts straight. And so Nathan Cruz is going to return. I cannot tell you how cool that is. Love it. And we're going to bring back more, so make sure to keep your eye out throughout the day for another online fan vote. And for the wrestlers, make sure to get your wrestling base behind it, because it could be very, very important. Because in the future, we will challenge the champions to make a pick out of two given choices, according to the ranking, who they would like to see face their opponent. Of course, we're hoping for a response, otherwise we're setting the action. That's the openness in which we will defend the championships. We hope that people will obey by those rules. Oh! London, great start of this match. Holy balls. But yeah, we're working out greatly. Seriously, we are. Make sure to check out The Raging Falcon, which is my personal channel. Two records on point, two videos, over 600 views, 660 nearly. 666 would be cool. Over three videos, which over another one is coming out today. So that personally, and of course you can always tweet me at The Raging Falcon, interim owner of RFPW. Of course, my name was the inspiration to this company once a while ago when I was the initial owner and it out to Jeffrey, but hey, that's a different kind of thing. This is the last time for my commentary duties, and I can tell you why. Let me tell you why, because later on tonight, later on tonight, next week onwards, you'll be seeing Joey Blyback on commentary. I'll be having to do back again. Rehired him, of course, because my commentary is just plain shit. Let's keep it at it going. We know that Jeffrey was supposed to have a match against Ospreay and Andrews in a triple threat match later on tonight. That match has been cancelled. We'll let you in on the information why just a little bit later on. We want to keep the tension, of course. I'll let you know when it would be that far, but it won't be that far tonight. Match cancelled. It just might be that we have to postpone that up until next week. Therefore, this show will be a bit shorter than expected. Although maybe we could stretch it up a little bit by just having a good talk and maybe some good, decent matches that could go the extra mile. The extra mile once was a podcast that we did. Lost exactly one episode. Nope. Oh, dude. Oh! Two. Jesus. It's crazy. Two. And everybody across the world, we hope you're all having a good day. If you do, please let us know in the chat or by the hitbox or Twitch. I'll leave you a good comment. And if you have any other questions about Leo from Dutch departure, about Cruz returning, the introduction of the point system, those three, of course, also all on the blog. Oh my goodness, huge flash by PJ Black. Or any other questions, please let us know. And that's it. What a huge job and match between these two guys in a flyweight division. But it's PJ Black landing the longest straw and therefore winning this match. Okay, and of course you saw it there. I was a bit confused. I thought we don't have this main event right now. But that's going to be a little bit later on. Steel Cage main event between Joe Coffey and BT Gunn. Moving on to singles action. Okay. I thought we were going on with tag team action, but apparently the cards are confusing. That's what happens when you get a match cancelled. Everything goes to shit. But it is, ladies and gentlemen, this guy from Zonstadt, or was he from Altmaier? I forgot. I'm so sorry, Tommy. Please don't beat me to a pulp. That would not be nice. Tommy Anders from Altmaier, the Netherlands. 180 tall, 96 kilos, and 30 years of age. Of course, from Netherlands, in his own country. Slight edge, always. But he's got a tough opponent here tonight. Let me tell you that. Oh, they're booing him. From right in the USA. 178 tall, 100 kilograms. And 29 years of age. Ladies and gentlemen, Jesse Goddard. We see ICM, manager of Erica Lee. How are you doing? Erica Lee, of course, the challenger for the Female Students' Championship. Later on today on the Academy 44. And Kim Light defends versus Erica Lee. Kim Light also teaming up with Ariella Wolf, AK-16, against who? Unknown, but that definitely will be a play out. Might be that the champions, the first, well, 2016, the Dets Tag Team Champions, have to be defending their titles against AK-16 later on today. Hope you're having a good day, RCM. And hope you're gonna enjoy this while we're at it. Match number 3 out of 6 today. One cancelled match. Let's see how that's gonna go. And that's why they call him Mr. Pactacular. Just look at him. Was a bitty builder before that. It's like you crossed Tanmon with, well, a good physique. That's basically how Jesse Goddard once looked. But hey, small people who we can say that of, especially somebody who is the big shot and the biggest promotion of them all. Or as you could call it, former twats. Oh, dude! I'm up to three. Tommy Ent wants to take this on the outside. Last week, of course, Jesse lost against Joe Hendry by countout. Of course, it was a stupid note to turn around the ring, was just running against the apron. Don't know what he was trying to do. Tommy Ant has to get back at 6. And he does so. This match will continue. Oh! Yeah, that's what we know from the Dutchman. Wow! Ladies and gentlemen, today we are bringing also to you Warground 13 and the Academy 44. So not one show, three shows here today for your enjoyment. And of course, it's only 11 days until the 2-year anniversary of this promotion. And it will be running 731 days. And of course, one who knows best what it's like to be champion. We'll invite him for a good interview on our blog. And that will of course be Emil Sitochi, 212 days as RFPW champion. Oh. Taken off the floor. So we'll have a good blog post. We're going to have a huge party on that 31st of March on Thursday. Because for the first time ever, we'll be hosting Shut Up and Wrestle. That's an IP pay-per-view. Third of this year on that very Thursday.
Oh!
good kick. Tommy End. Good night. Or it's not. I thought it could have been. Tommy End on 4 points right now. Got us on zilch. Oh, no. What now? Oh, he's going for the rack attack. Slow submission killing move. That could finish off Tommy End. And could see Goddess picking up his first victory. Ow. Yuch. Nope, counter. Oh, okay then. How about that? Tommy End's going to take it to the outside. Oh, he's going to crush the announce table of a local crew. Fucking god. I'm sorry about that, but oh god. Yeah, now you're gonna have to stand up there while I'm sitting here comfortably. Yeah, it's gonna be on there next week, RCM. Everything got fixed this weekend. Yep. Oh shit! Oh, good job. Oh no! Oh! Crying out loud. Does it have to be like that? Oh, running me. Good night, Jesse Goddess. Tommy End gets his third victory here. And I get him to 6 points. Congratulations, mate. And here is where we at. Ladies and gentlemen, it's that time. Please welcome your first team, the Challengers. First Challengers for the Dudettes Tag Team Championship. Introducing Jessica Thunder and the Glamazons champion, Candice LeRae Thunder Candy. Don't know what it's like to taste that candy, but I bet you're going to get a shock from it. Of course, it's 42 for Candice LeRae and 0-6 for Jessica Thunder, so Thunder really needs some help. And I think that just might kill up the chances. Because here is the other opposing team, the team of Flora Levity and Tanya Silkovich, Flora Silk. How original. You guys might have to work on that. Well, girls, sorry. I like Thunder Candy more. But hey, it's all about being the best team, and this team comes from the Academy. So in essence, it should be LeRae and Thunder, but Thunder's had an injury. 6 losses to her name, no wins. Since the introduction of the Order of Merit system. And here it is. Ooh, look at that, shiny. Wow. They're lovely titles. They're the best champ, the best looking championships that we've seen. Even better than the RFPW one, if honest. But hey, we can't have everything. There we go. who's going to walk away with that title? Ladies and gentlemen, receive word that we have another cancelled match, I'm afraid. Alexander and Strachan should be facing the Wolves here today. But unfortunately, something's happened in the back between them. And therefore, the board has decided to cancel the match. Investigation still ongoing as to what's been happening over there. But we'll keep you updated. Of course, the Wolves' new team, Billy Strachan returning. But not on stage. So we have two cancelled matches here today. That is not a good thing. We'll try to see if we can get them in a rebound. As possible exclusive RFPW Network matches, or whether to put them on the card for next week. I said everything has evolved. Into this morning, we've put it all on the blog. New point system alongside the Order of Merit. Nathan Cruz, former Genius TV champion and tag team champion, returning, as well as Leah Von Dutch departing away from us due to bad and inconsistent matches. Really bad. If you watched Fight Night 64, and if you haven't done so, make sure to do so, because it was very interesting. Fatal 4-way match for the RFPW Championship and Tag Team Championship on the line. It was Kyle O'Reilly able to defend that all? Make sure to watch that first. We don't want to spoiler it today for you. Spoilers! And also some great action, but it was Crazy Mary Dobson in the end that we can tell you. We walked away with the victory and made herself safe from elimination of the company. Yeah, they always say company, but we're not actually a company. We're only a wrestling promotion. Not a company with other business sides, sort of saying. Ow! So far, Silkovic from the Academy is working her way up. Now tag made to Flora Levity, but they're getting work on the Glamazons champion, and that's a good thing. Lorraine not trusting Thunder that much, I guess, to make the tag. Here we go. Oh, God, I thought she was going for the butt face plant, but not at all. Holy crap. Yo, good job. We have news. It seems the team of Alexander and Strachan backstage got into a heated argument with the Wolves that exploded. Fortunately broken on behalf of the roster who's backstage. But we have news. Billy Strachan is out. Been transported with the ambulance to the nearest medical facility, which is in Heerlen, the Netherlands. We have no update so far. We'll keep you updated throughout the night or throughout the day and on the blog. But there's more news to come, ladies and gentlemen, later on today. As far as the plans for year number 3, oh, Jesus. Good job by Levity and goes for the cover. As we chime year number 3 in for the company in 11 days. And we're working on very new ideas and we've got some of them listed. We'll let you know what that is soon. Oh! Silkovich tags himself in. Says, well, let's go. Nice DDT. Of course, Tanner out with head injury and neck injury. With those poor driver damages by Viper. But no, it's not enough. And she turn away around. Or will Tanner take in a seventh loss? Because it is for the Dudettes Tag Team Championship, it won't count for the individual rankings. But still, it is a blow for Tanner, not having won since the RFPW World Championship Tournament, where she won the Women's Championship in December last year. Jeez. Oh, breaker by LaRoy. Barely in the nick of time. Tanya from Switzerland taking it on. Oh. Oh man. Also, there will be rule packages coming out for the championships. Those are being composed by the board of directors in accordance with referees. We see on the outside Levity hooking up with LaRoy. Stanley's still in the ring. Oh man, got it all covered. Huge forearm there. And is this where she can get the cover from? Or she'll have to do more. Rule packages are coming into display. Oh my god! Over the apron. Cover? Or not? Tanner, good uppercut. Levity wants to see a tag, but it's not happening so far. Standing clothesline. Where is it going to go? Oh! That's not very nice, Tanya. Belly to belly suplex. And LaRoy is back at it again to break it up. We're planning a lot for year number 3, as said. We're moving up to TRFTV as well on Daily Motion. So we're moving across channels to get you started. Cover. Only a one count. Yeah. Tag mate to Candice LaRoy. What can the Amazons Championship do? Oh, good Eric Rowan off the top rope. Of course, Tanya had to move, but here we go. Levity breaks up after one. Tanya is following Levity, but that's not what we're in for. A side slam on Silkovich. And Tanya returns to her spot. Kick out a stretch to count. Is going to become the first Dudettes Tag Team Champions of 2016. Bernarda dominance lies with Team Flora Silk. Thunder Candy on the backside. Oh, Tornado DDT. Only a two count. Flora Levity, former Fight Night GM, kicks out. Oh, good job. We're not only setting rule packages, but also setting sort of a family tree when you can enter certain championship areas. We're getting fields of expertise back, which is quite important to get there. Out. Oh my god! Levity, huge spear! Oh, strikes and the referee! This could also end in disqualification. The referee will score that as an official end of the match. We will score it as Team Flora Silk winning. Silkovic and Tundra on the outside, good night! Candice LeRae, Levity! Cover! Oh, two count. What a great tag team match. And if you have any other questions, please let us know right now. Or if you have predictions. Also, do feel free to let us know who's going to win. Oh! So that means, with the two counts of matches after this, we're going to the Steel Cage main event. Lights went out shortly. Happens. And Levity misses dropkick but connects third time around because Thunder is too slow. Not at least responding to it. Silkovic back inside. Cover! Levity's got to be quick now! And it is! Oh, DDT, even after. Not much. Levity is happy, it seems. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, here are your winners. A new Dudettes Tag Team Champions, Flora Levity and Taya Silkovic, Flora Silk. Hey, the title looks magnificent and they've definitely earned that. Good job by these women. Lost nearly 15 minutes this match. Good effort in beating the Glamazons champion and the still winless Jessica Thunder. They're happy. I can get that. I get happy when I see people happy and that's a good thing. Because that allows us to all be better. Not be bitter, but be better. Okay. Just turn English I from E. I have to be a little bit on the pronunciation. Ladies and gentlemen, main event time. Steel cage match. And introducing first, it's BT Gun. He said, I can't get the purple and blue out of my hair and I want it gone. Okay, I can get that. We'll try to sort out a barbecue. You can do that. Your possibilities may be that either you will turn up bald or you can get the dye out. Okay. I'm always trying to read what's on his shirt, but we can never read it. Disappointing factors here. If you have a prediction for this main event, we will win the match. And we'll be happy to hear so. This BT Gun. And this champion is going to be one in form, ladies and gentlemen. That's a local announced team. Looking on. BT Gun get rid of his shirt quite quickly. There comes the man in grey. ladies and gentlemen, your world champion and number one of the world, Joe Coffey. And this man, the world champion, is 7 victories, 1 defeat, and a very defeat came to him last week on Boom by losing to his younger brother, Mark. That definitely doesn't count as a real flawless loss. Well, as a flaw or loss, I could say that. Still undefeated in my eyes. And not only that, but in the order of merit, we've got the statistics right here. He's got the longest reign as leader of the Order of Merit. 7 weeks, and of course, that's all time right now. Well, seriously, I'm very happy about this main event. Let's see how long it's going to last. Steel cage being lowered. It's going to be the gun versus the man in grey. The old of the Coffey brothers. And he's going straight away, climbing up. Don't know whether that's the best tactic you could have, but he's trying. But got on the counter. Once you get it going, it's 1 step in, 2 steps over, 3 steps. Oh, gun was really quick out of that. Nearly got it. Oh, no. Oh. What the fuck? Peter got so close to the victory right there, and then just a WTF moment happened. Well, OMG, I can't really control it. Uh-oh. What's happened? Oh no. Shit, what has happened? We've lost the footage. We're getting to it. Where is it? We're sorting it out.
Of the galaxy.
Just give us a moment. You're not allowed to swear, it's in the rules. LOL. It is. Commentary how everything happens. We have got this flashback feature. And that is what we're going to get it onwards with. So, there we go. That's good of a flashback function. We're always able to get it back. Had some heart wishes right there. So now a bit delayed and on demand, but we're still live, ladies and gentlemen. I can assure you of that. Yeah, we should get rule packages for the broadcast. Or change a contract with TRF TV. It's PG-13. Maybe make it an M-rated show. Then we're allowed to swear all the things that we can. Parental guidance advised under the age of 13. Kids, don't swear, at least not to your parents, to teachers, alright. Please make sure to not try these moves at home, school, or any other place unless you really train for it. And sometimes it goes 3 years of training and everybody still learns. As you can say, a live show, always everything could go wrong. Especially in this main event. And it's Joe Coffey climbing to the abilities. Everybody can get a place on the RFPW roster. As an amateur, you'll be trained by a pros in the academy. The only thing that we ask of you is that you're 2 weeks at least into the academy, sort of a trial run. Also quite inevitable they have to be in chat for those sessions, for those Chinese sessions, that you can see what's going to go down. Oh, gun in the corner. Wow, that's a good drop, isn't it? And it is not the only show, as mentioned. Later on today, we also have Warground 13 and the Academy 44, which is going to bring action to you. The Warground Championship on the line and on the Academy. We now get the official confirmation that Flora Silk will defend their Dudettes tag team titles against AK-16, Ariella Wolf and Kimberly Blight. Ryan Skills defending his Students' Championship and Kim Blight defending a Female Students' Championship. So the Academy is filled with action. And Joe Coffey tries again to scale the height of the cage. So there's more action coming to you today. Make sure to keep an eye on the blog for all those articles that are coming out. Make sure to subscribe to us at RFPW2014. Maybe send us a tweet or email, you know the drill. Everything can be found at rfpw2014.weebly.com. And for all the archives, history, shows, in detail, you can go to RagingFalconProWrestling.wikia.com. Think about them all now. And of course, with thanks to sponsors once again, OSWTV has had a heightened contribution, therefore, the intro is back. Oh, I tried to go for the cover on the automated system that we have. Of course, we can't send a referee in there, so we have an automated counting system that goes towards it. And that nearly was it. Coffee again. Must have scale height, but gets back down. And gone now. Two clotheslines. And a good super kick. Now he's got the shot at it. That's one step. That's two. Yeah, coming up. And Beatty guns on the outside. Coffey's not really even realizing it. And while Coffey turns around, he already sees the damage that has been done. Joe Coffey loses it the second time. Last week against his brother, this week to BT Gunn. Wins the Steel Cage main event. Thank you for watching. My name's been the Raging Falcon. This was Boom 57. Later on today, Warground 13 and the Academy 44. So make sure to keep an eye on Twitch.tv and Hitbox for the Raging Falcon, where TRFTV and RFPW present Raging Falcon Pro Wrestling. Thank you for watching, and have a good and safe day if we're not seeing you back or on the network. Dare, like, comment, and subscribe. And BT Gunn is happy. He's going to have a party with the crowd. For now, goodbye.